Thank you, and thank you for staying after lunch and coming back to hear me speak again.
谢谢, 就是各位, 就是在午餐之后有下来听我说话。
I have dreams that sometimes I speak someplace and then no one comes back.
其实曾经梦过说我就是在那边讲话，结果我讲一讲就没有人回来了。
So I appreciate you all coming back to hear me speak again.
所以我非常感谢各位都还留在这边听我说话。
This session will be called Practical Evangelism.
接下来这个主题叫做实物的传教。This
is more how we personally evangelize our friends and family.
那这个就是我们就是在个人上面如何去传，就是福音，传就是如何和家人或者是公司场合上面去传福音。Before
we get started, let's have a prayer.
那我们在这之前有祷告。
Blessed Father, we thank you for bringing us back together again.
亲爱的天父，就是感谢您让我们在这边都能够聚集在一起。Father,
I appreciate the willing spirit and tender hearts of everyone that's come back.
亲爱的天父，感谢各位，就是这边大家都有一个柔软的心，然后有一个柔软的灵，能够让我们在这边都再回来听。Be
with us as we study your word about how we can better spread the gospel.
我们在这边就是祷告，能够让我们这边各位的弟兄能够传，如何去有效的传福音。Father,
most of all, we thank you for Jesus, who gives us the reason for wanting to follow you.
那但是更重要的是，我们感谢耶稣，能够让我们在这边愿意有一颗心去跟随着耶稣。We
pray these things in Jesus' name, Amen.
以上祷告是奉主耶稣之名。Amen.
Okay, so this is practical evangelism. And I want to think for a few minutes here about Taiwan and people, what people are looking for.
我在这边想要花一些个人的时间向各位，就是在这边向台湾做感谢，就是台湾的人到底在找，人们在到底在寻求什么？
I think just like my country, Taiwan, people in Taiwan are looking for answers.
我觉得就台湾的人就像我们，像我们在美国的人一样，台湾人在找寻解答。
I think people are looking for something to believe in.
人们在找寻就是什么可以相信。People
are looking for something that they can count on.
人们在找寻什么是可以做依赖的。This
is a picture of an airplane.
这是一个飞机的照片。This
is a very famous airplane.
这是一个有名的飞机。
It's a Boeing 787, brand new airplane.
这是一个波音787的飞机。
Comes from one of the best companies in my country, Boeing.
那这个是从，就是一个从美国一个最好的公司出来的波音。
This is the pride of the United States of America.
这是美国的骄傲。
Many people put their faith in technology.
人们都喜欢把信仰放在科技上面。
This is a beautiful airplane, both inside and out.
这个就是也是一个非常美丽的飞机，从里到外。
It's quieter, more comfortable, has bigger windows.
那这是也是很安静的，从里到外有更大的窗户。
Kind of makes you want to fly in this airplane, doesn't it?
各位看到，你们都会想说，我想要在里面试试看，飞上天。
Isn't it just beautiful?
这是很美丽的。
Does anybody know the story of this airplane?
大家有人知道这个飞机的故事吗？
This airplane was first flying last year.
这架飞机在去年是第一次飞上天了。50
of them were built.
就是有50架。
Around January, they had two airplanes with fires.
大概在1月的时候有2架飞机着火了。
The government grounded this airplane in the United States.
那政府就已经把这个这种这个型号的飞机已经把它禁止飞行了。That
very rarely happens.
那个是其实是非常非常极少发生的。Because
there's so much money involved.
因为其实这里面牵扯很多的钱。Means
this was a very bad safety issue.
所以这是代表着这个里面有非常不安全的因素在里面了。This
is the box of batteries that caught on fire on one of the planes.
这个是在某一架飞机上着火的一个电池，看到就是烧成这样了。
Boeing has fixed this problem, and the airplane is now flying again.
那现在波音已经把这个飞机已经就是问题都修好了，那这个型号飞机也在飞了。
But not many people want to fly on this airplane yet.
但是其实没有很多人想在这个飞机上，这种飞机上飞。
The point of this is that you can't believe in technology and things created by man.
重点是人们其实不能真的相信，就是人们所创造的真的，信赖这个所创造的科技。
As beautiful and perfect as this airplane looks, it had flaws.
就是虽然这个飞机看起来是这么的完美，这么的漂亮，但是其实这里面有缺陷。
It's hard to believe I'm talking about this, and I'm flying to the United States on Monday.
很难想象，其实我现在正在说着这个飞机，可是我礼拜我就要坐这个飞机回去。
The point of this is that you cannot put your faith in things made by man.
重点是我们不能真的信赖人类所创造的科技。
So what are some things we can put faith in? What about the stock market?
那我们到底能够相信什么呢？就是像股市吗？
That's a good thing, right? You can put your faith in the stock market and all your money.
我们能够把我们的信心放在股市上吗？和把钱放在股市里面吗？
Probably not. I've seen the stock market drop a lot and people lose all their money.
也许不行，因为我也曾经看到很多人把钱放在股市，然后就跌得很惨。
What about faith in our jobs? Can we have faith in our jobs?
各位会把信仰放在自己的工作吗
？Is your employer going to always take care of you?
认为就是雇主会永远就是照顾你吗
？Does your employer really care about you?
那雇主真的很关心您吗
？In my country, it's very clear.The employer does not care about you.
在我的国家其实是非常明确的，就是雇主是不在乎员工的。
I think that's true in Taiwan too.
在台湾，我认为也是一样的。
I've worked in the same place for 25 years.
我在同一个地方待了工作25年。
So I put some faith in my company.
所以我也放了一些信心在里面。
But I know that if they didn't need me, they would get rid of me very fast.
但是我也知道，如果他们不需要我，他们将会就是赶快就把我踢走。
So what do we put our faith in?
所以到底我们要放什么放信心在哪里呢
？Well, there's other people. We can put faith in our families.
那也许我们会说，我们把信心放在家人上面。
I love my family, but sometimes they can let me down.
我很爱我的家庭，但是我知道我的家人有时候也会让我感到失落。
I have a sister in my family who has drinking problem.
我有一个姐姐或妹妹，她其实有就是酗酒的习惯。
We call her the black sheep of the family.
我们称她为就是黑羊在这家里面。
I haven't seen her in 5 years.
我已经5年没有看到她了。
But so it's hard to put faith in our families.
所以其实我们也很难在家庭当中放入信心。
What about famous leaders or religious leaders? Can we put faith in them?
那我们会在宗教的领袖上面放信心吗
？What about that preacher who's really good on Sunday morning? Can we put our faith in him?
那我们可以想想，是不是有一位很会讲话的牧师在我们在礼拜天早上，我们会在他身上放信心吗
？While there are many, many good preachers, you really can't put your faith in any one person.
但是其实我们也知道很不能够把信心放在很多很多很好的厉害的牧师身上。
There are many things to believe in today's world.
今天人们会相信很多事情在这个世界上。
This is just an example of some of the things that we can believe in.
这张图展现的就是有一些例子。
I want to turn to Matthew 6:19-21.
那我们可以看到马太福音的第六章的19-21.
Matthew 6:19-21.
马太福音的第六章的19-21.
Do not store up for yourself treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal.But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For For where your treasure is, your heart, there your heart will be also.
第六章的十九节到二十一节，不要为自己积攒财宝在地上，地上有虫子咬能锈坏，也有贼挖窟空。窟窿来偷，只要积攒财宝在天上，天上没有虫子咬，不能锈坏，也没有贼挖窟窿来偷你，因为你的财宝在那里，心也在那里。
So, does anybody know what these symbols mean? Does anybody know what this means?
各位有人知道这个符号代表是什么吗？
Jewish, Judaism. So you know what this is? Buddha?This is money. This is some preacher or religious leader. Anybody know what this is? Islam.
So we can see here the symbol. We can see the Jewish symbol, the Jewish symbol, the Jewish symbol, the Jewish symbol, the money, some religious leader, and Islam.
So there are many things to believe in today's society.
所以今天我们有很多事情可以去相信，在这个社会上有很多事情可以去，很多东西可以去相信。
It can be very confusing, and some people mix all these things together and come up with their own belief.
有时候我们也会听到，就是有些人会把所有东西都合在一起，然后就把它编撰成一个自己的信仰了。
Again, people are looking for something. They're trying to find some meaning in their lives.
那就是再一次的，其实人们都很想要去找一个可以去相信，但是在生命中可以去相信的东西。
I have a quote on this page from a guy named G.K. Chesterton. Let me read this quote. The trouble when people stop believing in God is not that they thereafter believe in nothing, it is that thereafter they believe in everything.
这边看到一段短短的短句，是由 G.K. Chesterton 这个人所说的，这句话这边翻译是说，就是当人们开始停止相信神的问题，不是在于那个他们什么都不相信了，是在于他们开始什么都相信了。
I don't know very many people who totally don't believe in God.
我其实不认识很多人，他们说我完全不相信神，我不认为有一个神。
They believe in some kind of spiritual being or some kind of a god that they believe runs through the universe.
他们通常都相信说有，就是有某种神或某种灵，然后这边或者是某种东西存在于宇宙。
There's a term for this that I want you to remember called pluralism.
那我希望就是我这边讲了一个，就是有一个单字叫做。复数主义者就是多重主义的一种单字一个字。
Pluralism means that you believe in many different beliefs and different religions.
那复数主义 plural 就是比如说我们会说单数、复数，那或者是多重的。那多重复数的这个主义就是代表说他们相信很多很多事情。
This can lead to many fad religions or cults.
那其实这样的可能就会导致说带就是引导进一种就是狂热主义，或者是说一种创造出来的一种主义。
Have you ever heard of something called the Christian Scientists?
不知道各位有没有听过基督科学教
？Doesn't seem like you have. That's a good thing.
就是听起来跟我们这边这个很像，就是是一个很好的东西去相信，不是吗？
A very controversial group in the United States that sort of believes in everything, but nothing.
刚刚那个教叫三达教，想起来了，是吗？三达教，对，那三达教就是他们相信，就是很多东西都可以相信，什么东西都可以相信。
Many celebrities belong to this group.
那其实也知道很多美国的名人，他们是相信三达教的。
So what distinguishes the church from all of these different things that I've talked about?
那我们到底就是到底是什么东西分开了我们和其他的宗教呢？或者是真理和其他宗教呢？
Quite simply, it's Jesus that makes the church different.
那其实很简单，就是耶稣让这个教会变得不一样。
The church is a community of believers. It's a place to belong.
Can you say that again?
The church is a community of believers that is a place to belong.
Okay. 那个教会是一个社团所人们愿意去的地方，然后还有就是一群人所拥有、所去归、所去拥有的。
More than anything else, the church is a place to believe in Jesus.
那或者或这个地方也是一个人们愿意相信这个耶稣是救主的一个地方。
We talked about some of the things that people in Taiwan are looking for.
我们曾经说到了说，就是人们在台湾的人们到底在找什么呢？
Material possessions, desire to belong, social connections.
那我们在找，人们的可能是在找。Can you say that again?
Material possessions, desires to belong, and social connections.
物质主义啊，然后，就是归属感，然后。
Social connections. Friends, looking for friends.
朋友啊。
Many people have issues that they need help with.
其实人们有时候会有一些，就是希望想要，就是有一些问题，希望朋友可以帮助他们。
Many people have family issues, and they have job issues or financial issues.
人们可能有家里面的问题啊，然后就是工作的问题啊，或者是一些其他的问题，家庭的。
The church needs to be prepared to address and help people with these issues.
那教会就应该要能够针对这个不同的问题，然后随时准备好，能够帮助这些问题，帮助这些人。
So what can the church provide?
教会可以提供什么？
It can provide a place to belong.
它可以就是有一个地方可以让人家去住。
It can provide common interests. Remember that word affinity.
各位可能刚才有提到亲属感跟归属感。可能有一个地方可以让人家提供这个亲属跟归属感。
And finally, and most important, the church can provide love.
但是更重要的是，教会可以提供爱。
So are you ready to be an evangelist?
所以各位已经准备好要做一个传教者了吗？
This is something else the church can provide, and this is just a picture to remind us that the church can provide friendship.
那这一张照片实际上就是提醒了我，这个教会也会提供友谊。
This guy right here, he's my friend.
这个左边这个家伙就是我的朋友。
We were very hot this day. I was.
这天是很热很热的天。
We made it to the top.
然后我们爬到我们宫顶。
As we think about becoming evangelists, I have a question. Is your act sharp?
那成为一个有效的传教者，我们会问说你的斧头是不是尖锐的。
Anybody here ever chopped down a tree?
各位不知道有没有砍倒过一棵树。
Trees, okay. Have you ever chopped down a tree with a dull axe?
如果曾经砍倒树或没有砍，就是如果用一个很钝的斧头的话。
You keep chopping and chopping and chopping.Nothing happens.
就会是发生一直不断的砍树，然后什么都没有发生。
You get mad and you chop harder and harder and harder.
那也许我们会变得很生气，然后我们就还是更用力的砍。
But your axe is dull.
但是其实就是那个斧头是钝的。
The best thing to do is to stop chopping.
最好的方法就是不要砍了。
Take your axe and go sharpen your axe.
然后把自己的斧头带回去，然后把它磨尖锐。
It's so much easier to chop down a tree with a sharp axe.
这个是非常非常更轻松的，就是可以把用尖锐的斧头把一棵树砍倒。
So Alan, why are you talking about chopping down trees?
那为什么 Alan 啊，你今天要提到砍树呢？
So if we're to be evangelists, we must know what we're talking about. We must understand what we're trying to communicate.
那我们今天如果知道我们想要传教的话，我们想要传导福音的话，我们必须要知道如何，就是一个方法。
Our axe must be sharp. In other words, we must study to understand how to teach someone to become a Christian.
那我们就要就是磨尖我们的斧头，然后知道一些知识，然后我们如何去跟人家沟通。
The good news is you don't have to have an advanced Bible degree to teach someone about Jesus.
其实非常，这个好消息是我们根本不需要一些进阶的圣经的知识来做一个传导者。
You can sharpen your axe just by studying about Jesus.
其实就是很简单的，只要 能够念圣经，然后知道圣经的故，知道耶稣的故事，就可以做一个传道者了。
The story of Jesus is very simple yet very powerful.
耶稣的故事是非常简单，但是非常的有力的。
So how do we get ready to teach someone about Jesus?
那我们要如何教导别人有关耶稣的故事呢？
Another term I want you to remember called spiritual formation.
一个简单的说法就是一个属灵的形成。
We studied this last fall at the Taipei Church of Christ.
我们根据属灵的形成这个主题，在去年的秋天开始就也开始有这个课主题。
It's what happens to us after we're baptized.
这个是讲的就是。一些我们在属灵的形成在受洗之后一些经历。
Some of the things that make up spiritual formation are studying, praying, and worship.
那某些发现有些不同的包含了就是我们会包含读经啊，然后祷告啊，然后还有学习圣经的事情。
The Holy Spirit is also an important part of spiritual formation.
圣灵的了解还有圣灵的得到也是一个在这个属灵的形成当中的一个重要主题。
We receive the Holy Spirit when we're baptized.
我们得到了圣灵就在我们受洗的那一瞬间。
Other things that help with spiritual formation are learning how to meditate and think about God's Word.
另外一件事情就是在我们祷告的时候我们也同时是在默想静思然后能够让我们静思把这些神的话语能够读到心里
A great way to do that is to spend time in nature
那一个好的方法也就是和大自然亲近
Find a place in God's creation where you can pray and meditate
那一个就是在大自然里面我们可以找到一个好安静的地方然后并且去做冥思的动作
You study about Jesus, that's how he prayed when you think he went to the garden alone
我们其实想象在耶稣的故事当中他常常在大自然然后自己去祷告或者是静思
To be effective evangelists, we must separate ourselves from the world
那要成为一个有效的传教者我们必须要和这个世界分开
Would you turn with me, please, to Romans 12, verse 2.
各位可以打开罗马书的第十二章第二节。罗马书的第十二章第二节。
Romans 12, 2. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will.
第十二章的第二节这边开始说了不要效法这个世界只要心意更新而变化叫你们查验为何神的善良纯全可喜悦的旨意我凭着所赐的恩对你们个人说不要看自己过于所当然 要照看神吩咐的各位的信心大小合乎
So we must be in the world, but we're not of the world.
所以我们都在这个世界里，但是我们不是跟随着这个世界。
That's a very important difference.
这是一个非常重要的一个差别。
Christ was in the world.
基督就在这个世界里。
But he was not of the world.
刚刚是基督曾经站在世界里，但是他也不在这个世界里。
We're not called to go live by ourselves on a mountaintop.
我们不是被呼叫或者是呼召到这边来说我们要去独居在山里面的。
We are called to interact and spend time with other people.
我们是被叫来说我们要和其他人有所交流的。
In order to save people or to tell people about Jesus, we have to be around people.
那为了要就是和能够和各位跟大家分享就是耶稣的故事我们必须要能够和世人能够有所交流
We have to have friends and be friendly
我们必须要有朋友也必须要很友善的
It's an important part of teaching others is that we have friends and that we are friendly
那就是很重要的就是我们要能够 教导别人，然后但是也同时和人家做朋友，然后并且是友善的和人家去做交流。
In addition, people watch you, non-Christians watch you, how you behave and how you act.
那更重要的其实是不是只有我们在就是人们都会看着你，不是只有基督徒看着你，就是世人也会看着你是怎么样的人，尤其是看着基督徒。
A big part of being evangelist is living a Christ-like life that others recognize.
那有一个重要的重点就是能够像，就是像是就像是模仿耶稣一样，像着基督一样活自己的生命。
So after we're baptized, are we mature Christians?
那当我们受洗的时候，我们就算是一个成熟的一个基督徒或者是传道者了吗？
No, I don't think that we are. We have to continue to grow as Christians.
不，我不认为我们是的。我们必须要不断的继续去成长。
This lot, you can tell I like bridges here, right?
我们可以看到这边有一个桥。
So this is talking about what happens to us that transitions us from a converted Christian to an evangelist.
那我们可以看到这个桥的左右两边，一个是已经转变的基督徒，另外一边是一个基督徒的传道者。
We'll talk about sowers and reapers more in a few minutes.
我们将会停止在那边。
Sowers and reapers.
我们将会讲到就是那个收成者跟撒种者。
But for now, I want you to think about what needs to happen for you to come from converted Christian to becoming an evangelist.
但是我们现在将会专心放在就是刚转变成的基督徒，然后还有一个基督徒的传福音者。
And I think that gets back to the areas I talked about earlier around study, pray, worship.
那也会，也许等下待会会提到的，就是我们刚刚提到的，那个敬拜，然后祷告跟那个祷告，还有就是什么？
And most important, allowing the Holy Spirit to work in your life.
但是更重要的是，让自己的圣灵得到的圣灵能够如何有效的在这个世界上运用。
The steps of becoming a Christian are to hear, believe, repent, confess, and be baptized.
那几个比较重要的重点就是听去第一个相信，第一个去听到，然后第二个去相信，第三个是悔改。第四个是能够承认罪，第五个就是受洗，然后最后就是变成一个信实的。
The most important part of becoming an evangelist is to be faithful.
那最后一个变成能够基督徒传道者，就是能够变成一个信实的人。
We're all called to be evangelists, but we must be evangelists of faith.
基督徒们其实都应该是一个传道者，但是我们都是，就是靠着一个信实的信心，才是会有是一个有效的传道者。
Think back to the Great Commission. Jesus tells us all that we're to go into the world and preach the gospel to everyone.
那我们回到之前曾经提过的，在马太福音二十八章的刚刚提到的，就是耶稣走复活之后说到的大使命呢？就是如何要有效的和这个世界做交锋。
When we are converted to be Christians, we are also converted to be evangelists.
当我们转变成基督徒的时候，同时我们其实也瞬间也是成为一个基督徒的传福音者。
Now let's talk about sowers and reapers.
那我们来提提所谓的播种者和撒种者。
Turn to John chapter 4.
那可以打开约翰福音的第四章
35-37,
在35-37。
John 44, 35-37.
约翰福音的第四章的35-37。
Don't you have a saying, it's still 4 months until harvest? I tell you, open your eyes and look at the fields. They are ripe for harvest.Even now, the one who reaps draws a wage and harvests a crop for eternal life, so that the sower and the reaper may be glad together. Thus the saying, one sows and another reaps is true.
约翰福音第四章三十五节到三十七节，你们不是说到收割的时候还有四个月吗？我告诉你们，举目向田观看，庄稼熟了，可以收割了。收割的人可以得到工钱，为永生储存五谷，使撒种和收割的一同快乐。那人撒种，这人收割，这话可是真的，可见是真的。
A sower is somebody who plants the seeds.
这个撒种者就是有这个一个人，他是撒种的人。
We're all called to be sowers, to plant seeds.
我们都是，其实都是一个撒种的人。
We do this by inviting people to church, inviting them to church events, and telling them about Jesus.
我们在撒种的时候，也许就像是平常会问有没有人要来教会，或者是有时候邀请大家，邀请个人来教会啊。
Sowing starts the process of belonging to Jesus.
那撒种这个过程其实也是一个就是属于耶稣的这个过程。
It's important for sowers and for everyone to live a Christ-like life.
其实撒种的人是非常重要的，是让就是像是一个自己也是过着一个像基督的类似基督属基督的一个生活。
A reaper is another word for a teacher.
那收割者就是其实在另外一个字面上的意义是老师。
It's someone who collects the harvest.
那他这个 reaper 就是收割者，就是这些收集这些成熟的农作物的人。
This is someone who teaches the good news of Christ to a prospect.
就是收割者在某个层面来讲，也就是教导耶稣跟教导耶稣的话的人。
As I mentioned earlier, a Bible degree is not necessary.
就像我之前所提到的，有一个圣经的一个那个学历是没有的。
You simply have to learn and tell the story of Jesus.
我们就是很简单的，就是和大家提到说跟大家分享耶稣的故事而已啊。
Some of the key points are.
那有些重要的关键就是
deity. Jesus was God and came down to be on the earth.
第一点就是神圣的，耶稣是一个唯一的神，然后他来凡间。
Jesus was born of a virgin.
第二点是耶稣他是一个处女怀孕生子的。
Jesus was raised as a Jew.
那耶稣他是一个犹太人。
Jesus lived a sin-free life.
那耶稣在他的生命当中是没有任何罪的。
This is the most important part here.
那接下来这点也是最重要的一点。
Jesus willingly died on the cross to forgive our sins.
耶稣他是自愿去上十字架死亡，然后就是为了要原谅我们的罪的。
Jesus was raised again to a new birth.
那耶稣他在死后三天复活，然后并且就是重生。
And Jesus ascended to heaven.
最后耶稣升到天上了。
That's the story of Jesus.
这个就是耶稣的故事啊。
I'm willing to believe that most of you can learn this story.
我其实很愿意相信各边在座所有的人都可以学到这个故事。
Many people are intimidated to teach others because they are afraid of questions they may get asked.
其实很多人很害怕分享这个故事，因为他们很害怕说，一些人就开始问说这个故事是怎样啊。
Maybe you don't know the answer immediately and you feel bad.
也许你会说我不知道这个答案啊，那你就会觉得自己糟糕啊。
I've been a Christian for over 40 years.
我其实已经作为基督徒40年了。
People ask me questions all the time. I don't know.
其实每次人家问我问题，我都随时随地问我问题。我很多时候都是说我不知道啊。
I have a good friend who's a Bible professor at Harding University.
我有一个好朋友，他在哈丁大学教神学的。
He's written many books and papers about religion.
他其实写过很多论文，有关宗教啊、神啊、信仰各方面的。
He has told me, and he will tell you, people ask him questions. He doesn't know the answer.
他就会跟我讲说，很多人有时候问他问题，他也都说他都不知道啊。
It's okay to say I don't know. I need to study, and I will get back to you.
当我们知道，当我们不知道答案的时候，是可以说我不知道，然后我等一下再跟你说吧。就是不要，不是，是可以的 ，OK 的。
You can tell people we're on a learning journey together.
你可以跟人家说，我们可以一起在这个找答案的旅程一起做，一起啊，一起走下去啊。
So don't be afraid to teach someone about Jesus.
所以不用害怕去跟别人分享耶稣的故事。
Some people are afraid maybe I'll teach them the wrong thing.
也许有些人会想说，也许我会教到错的事情啊。
Again, the story of Jesus is not very complicated.
就是重说一次，就是再来一次，这个耶稣的故事其实没有这么的复杂呀。
It's okay to ask for help from somebody who's taught more.
那我们也可以再跟问人家说，到底这个有什么？你可以问人家说，可不可以帮助我？可以去问一下其他人。
But I encourage you to try to teach yourself.
但是我鼓励各位都可以试着自己去教导。
That being said, not everyone is called to be a teacher.
就是，就像侍从所说的，就是大家都不是每个人都是老师，但是每个人都可以是老师。都也可以去教教看。
So James chapter 3 verse 1.
那在雅各书的第三章的第一节就说到了。
Not many of you should become teachers, my fellow believers, because you know that we who teach will be judged more strictly.
在雅各书的第三章的第一节说到了，我的弟兄们，不要多人做师父，因为晓得我们要受更重的判断。原来我们在许多事情上都有过失。若在人的话语上没有过失，他就是完全人，也能勒住自己的全身。
But don't let that verse scare you.
但是不用让这个章节的话，就是让你觉得害怕。
What that verse means to me is that I just need to study before I teach.
其实那个章节的意思就是说，我必须要在教导之前能够先自己学习。
I hope and pray that some of you will try to be teachers.
我希望在座的各位有些人可以愿意能够成为老师。
The world, the church needs more teachers.
这个世界，这些教会都需要更多人去愿意去教导别人。
So how do we approach telling someone about Jesus?
那我们要如何开始去跟人家分享，然后教导耶稣的故事呢？
We talked earlier about used car salesman.
那我们刚刚有提到汽车的销售员。
That's the wrong approach.
那汽车销售员是一个错误的开始。
Of everything that I've said today, this is the one word I want you to take with you: spiritual friendship.
那我今天希望各位可以在今天也可以记住这个字的，就是说一个属灵上的朋友。
What it means is helping people put together a worldview of beliefs that makes sense.
那这个字的意思就是说帮助别人，然后能够把自己把那个世界的观点，然后和这些信仰，然后并且帮助朋友，然后甚至
，Oops, sorry.
帮助朋友，然后，把这个世界的观点和信仰，然后让他们能够去看到这个不同。
It's taking all these different things and putting them together into something that makes sense.
那其实就是把这张图上面的东西能够放在一起，然后让每个人去了解。
To be a spiritual friend, you have to get to know someone.
那当然，成为一个属灵上的朋友，你会认识一个人。
You have to get involved in their lives.
那就是当然，你自己的生活跟自己的生命也都会和他们的生命也都会牵扯在其中。
You have to ask questions and spend time with people.
我们就会问问题，然后并且愿意去花时间。
That's a key word, time. I talked earlier how busy everyone is.
那个是一个非常重要的字，就是时间。那我们刚刚也提到，大家似乎都很忙啊。
It takes time to get involved in other people's lives.
但是其实如果要进到一个人生命，就是要花时间。
Some people's lives are very messy, and you may not want to get involved.
有些人的生命也许就是很乱七八糟的，也许你根本也不想要进到他的生命，走到他的生命。
That is when Christians are needed the most.
但是这个其实就是一个基督徒最需要的呀。
Think about Jesus. He was always involved in people's lives who had problems.
那如果各位想，各位念圣经有想到耶稣的故事，耶稣常常就是走到这些刚刚说的乱七八糟的人的生活当中啊。
Think about the woman at the well and how many problems she had.
那想想看，就是在井里面的那个女人，她是多么的有问题啊。
Jesus should not have even been talking to her.
耶稣其实根本不应该要跟她讲话呀。
But he did, and that's what we should do as well.
但是他其实就是走到了他的生命，那也这也正是一个基督徒应该要做的事情啊。
We need to help people see the benefits of being a Christian.
我们必须要让人们可以看到说，相信基督的好处，基督的好处是什么呢？
We need to start with our friends.
我们可以从我们的朋友开始。
I'm just guessing that you all have some friends.
我只是在猜各位这边每个人都应该有朋友。
You seem like pretty friendly people, so I think you have friends.
大家看起来都非常的友善，所以大家应该都有朋友。
Those are the people you need to talk to about Jesus.
这些朋友就是各位愿意应该要去和人家说明说话，然后就是讲耶稣的故事的。
You like them and you spend time with them. Don't you want them to learn about Jesus?
你喜欢这些朋友啊，那你也愿意和这些人相处，那你应该也会希望他们知道耶稣的故事嘛。
First, we want to help them to belong, invite them to events like this or social events at the church.
那也许首先我们可以让他们来，有时候来教会，然后就是一些社交的场合，刚刚说到的社交的场合，然后邀请他们到这些活动里面啊。
And when they're ready, or when they can answer the question, we teach them about Jesus.
那当你觉得他们已经准备好的时候，你就可以和他们分享说，耶稣的故事是怎么样，或者是教导。
The key is to not put too much pressure on someone.
那这个重点是我们不要在上面多增加压力。
If someone asks me all the time to study about Jesus and I'm not ready, I'm probably going to leave.
如果有人问我说，总是在问我说，你要不要来读耶稣，然后你要不要来读耶稣？你要不要来读跟有认识，就是读圣经，或者是读，那有时候我根本就觉得很烦了，那我可能就会转头就走。
On the other side, we must eventually talk to people about Jesus.
但是在另外一方面，去想的话，我们总是会有这一个时间，和这些朋友相处的时候，总是会有这个时间，可以有机会和他们说有耶稣啊。
The church is not just a social club; it has an element of spirituality.
那教会当然也不是一个社交的一个场合，教会总是有包含就是属灵上面还有神的事工的一个元素在里面的地方。
So I encourage you not to wait to be an evangelist.
所以我鼓励各位都不要等待说我就等待说我什么时候才要变成一个传道者或传讲者。
A key question to answer is how do I sustain my enthusiasm for evangelism?
那一个好的问题问自己的就是说，我如何去维持自己一个热情，然后能够自己在做一个分享或传道的一个工作的事情的上面的时候，我是有热情的。
A few weeks ago at our church, I preached a sermon about a young man who was very excited about Jesus.